All right. Do you see the link there? Okay. Please copy and paste that to an online edit to your browser. Okay. Open a tab on your Chrome, and you should see something similar to this one. This is a Java online compiler from OnlineGDB. Okay. So we can start coding. All right. Now, a couple of things before we code. The name of the class here is called main. All right. Since this is an online compiler, let's not change anything. All right. In line 9 to 11. The class is main. And for brevity, let's call line 11 as PSVM. All right. So if you hear me say public static void main, that's too long. I would rather say it as PSVM. It means public static void main. Okay. Now, let me explain line 12. So if you wanted to print something, all right, let's say hello, and then I'll say Lawrence. Okay. So hello, Lawrence. And if you want to test this, you see the run button on the upper middle part or on the upper left part. Click that one and your code will be read. It will be compiled and you will see hello, Lawrence right here. Okay. All right. Sige. Now go ahead and try to put your name right here and try to run it. And I would like you to paste or copy the output and then paste it in the chat box for me to see that you're already running it. So I will highlight this one, right click, copy, and then I'll paste it right here in the chat box, paste, and then output. That's what I got. Okay. All right, so you see, hello, Lawrence, is printing. How about you guys? Can you type in your name? I will be using my text editor, all right, to explain a little bit further about our sample code. Now, when we say system.out.println right here, like what we have in our online compiler, you're supposed to display something. Oh, by the way, if you hear me say SOP, I'm referring to system.out.println. Okay, it's usually followed by a pair of parentheses, and everything inside a pair of double quotes will be printed as is. So in our case, in our online editor, you said, hello, Lawrence, then you're printing the value, hello, Lawrence. So if you wanted to print something else, let's say you wanted to print a numeric value, so you still type system. Okay, let me just type that one. System.out.println. And then I would like to print the sum of 100 plus 200. All right? Don't put them inside a pair of double quotes. Just the numeric value of 100 plus 200. And don't forget to put a semicolon. So after adding this line of code and I press run, okay, should see that we're getting the value 300. Okay, so what do we mean by this? When we wanted to print something, sorry about that. We normally use system.out.println, all right? And if you want to print a text, a string value, you can put that string value inside a pair of double quotes. If you want to print, let's say your numeric value, let's say your age value, and you wanted to put some computation inside, you can directly put them, but never put them inside a pair of double quotes. Okay, so that the mathematical equation that you wanted to do, let's say, let me do this, 100 plus 200 minus 50, and then I click run, this mathematical value will be evaluated. So I'm getting 250, all right? Because 100 plus 200 minus 50 should be 250. So if I put this numeric equation, let me just do a quick copy, paste right here. And let's say I put them inside a pair of double quotes. right? These values inside a pair of double quotes will be printed as is. You won't be able to perform any mathematical computation. So if I click run, I should have three outputs, okay? The first line is hello Lawrence, 250, and the last one is the one that you're trying to print in line 14. All right? Okay, now we can also combine displaying a value, a string value, and let's say a numeric value. Let's say I wanted to print my name. Okay, Lawrence, let's say system.out.println. Let's say Lawrence at age, colon, space, and then I will type in my age. Please don't tell anybody about my age, all right? I'm 40 years old. So how are we supposed to, what are we supposed to get if we run this? If we run this, you'll see that I'm getting Lawrence at age 40, all right? Because 40 is a numeric value and Lawrence at age something is a string value. Now the plus operator is functioning as a concatenation operator, all right? It's not running, it's not functioning as a addition symbol. It's running as a concatenation operator. So what I meant was, the plus operator, let me just put them inside the comment. Oh, by the way, in Java, if you start something with a double slash, it means a comment. When you say comment, it will not be read by the entire code. So it can be, the plus, it can be used for addition and for concatenation. When you say concatenation, putting things together, no computation. All right, so if we have this, let's say system.out.println. Let's say I have a value of x right here. Now this one right here should cause a compilation error. Now let me just comment some of the few codes that we've written already, okay? I'm just exposing line 16, okay? So in line 16, I have SOP system.out.println x. If I click run, this should give me an error. Boom, there's an error right here. It says, cannot find symbol. Why? Because Java doesn't know who X is. But if we declare a variable on top of that, let's say I'll insert this, int X equals to 100, semicolon. And if I run this again, click run, we should see that we have a successful runtime and the value that is being printed is 100. 100 is the numeric value of x. Okay? So since x is declared as 100 right here, we're getting x right here. Now, if we try to put, all right, let's say, let's try to put x inside a pair of double quotes, then we're going to have an output of whatever's inside a double quote, which is x. Right here. So 100 and then X. All right? Now, let's try to see if you can answer this question. Okay? Now, what if I would like to get this output? X equals 100. Now, 100 is the declared value of X in line 16. And I would like to get X equals and then the value of 100. Can you type in the chat box, what statement should I put in line 19 so that I can get this specific output right here?
Be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps and also read some great articles on their blog page.